Welcome back, Tigers. This is part 3 in the DocuSign for Salesforce integration series. In this video, we will show you how to use auto-place fields in your documents. These fields are useful in the scenario where you are uploading a document that needs to be signed and not using a template you've already configured with DocuSign custom merge fields. The auto-place fields allow you to pre-populate the document with data from Salesforce. You can also assign the auto-place fields to specific signers so they can update information while signing, and then you can write that data back to Salesforce. Let's check out some examples on how auto-place fields can help you be more efficient with pre-populating your documents. Our first step is to create a DocuSign envelope template. Click New here. And we're going to name this Opportunity Upload Document. So in our scenario, the user is going to click a button and needs the ability to upload a document for e-signature. So we'll leave this set to Upload Document. We're going to add our recipients. We're going to pull the recipients from the opportunity contact roles. The contact role will be signer one. And then we'll add a second recipient that is going to be an internal user as signer two. Since we have two signers, we want to apply a signing order so this routes to the first signer first and then goes to the second signer after the first one has finished signing. We'll click Next. And then here's where we need to see if we need to create any new merge fields and how we need to update our existing merge fields to have auto-place anchor text. Now here's our document. So we have a proposal and maybe your scenario is this document changes all the time. And there's a couple of fields that are consistent from proposal to proposal, but the teams really need to be able to have the flexibility to craft these proposals in Word and then upload them into DocuSign when they're ready to send it out. So for these common fields that they always want populated, like company name and phone and address, we don't want them to have to drag and drop the merge fields in the DocuSign screen because that can be really time consuming. We want to put in here auto place text so that the field merges are automatically pulled into this document when they send it for signature. So we're going to do a couple of examples here. Company name and phone, let's do those two examples. So we have this merge field right here that says op account name. So let's edit this. And we can see that this is pulling from the account that's related to the opportunity and then pulling the account name. Now we have this called anchor text, and this is where we put the following syntax. So you put a slash and then you can make up whatever name you want. It can't have any spaces in it. So we're going to call ours op account name. Then you'll do an underscore braces are braces underscore text. This is so that you can make either a text or a checkbox. We're going to show you only text fields in our examples today. So we will click save here. And then how that translates into your document is if you paste this here, then you just replace this R with a one. And this means that this will apply to signer one. If you're collecting data from a signer, you will need to make sure that you assign the correct signer that you're collecting the data from. So in our example, signer one is the prospect, signer two is the internal person. So I would want to make sure that I assign all fields to signer one. Now let's do our phone number. Here's our op account phone. I will click edit. And then the syntax for this one that we're going to use is op account phone underscore, then the R and the braces underscore text. We'll click save. And then we will add that to our document here and we will replace the R with a one. Now this also works for your related lists. The syntax is a little bit different though. So in our proposal, we do have a place for our product names and our product costs. So if we go to our product name, let's see here, it's op pricebook entry product name. So we can see that this is pulling from the op product and then going to the pricebook entry and pulling the product name. The syntax here is a little bit different in that you are specifying inside the braces the roll number and then which row it is. So you can do, in the example in the documentation from DocuSign, it only goes up to 5. I'm not sure if there's a limit. I haven't tested the limit out. But this is what it would look like. If you have more, you can try out going 1-10. So we will click save. And then how that translates into your document is you will put in slash op product name 1_1. So this is assigned to signer 1, and then this is the first product that's listed in your opportunity products. To list the second one, you're going to change this to a 2. The third one, you will change this to a 3, and so on. Then same with your cost. You can do the same thing over there. So that should be our total price. So we can see that this is pulling from the total price of the opportunity product. Our anchor text, we will just change the product name to say price. And then in our document, we will change this to say price. And then we will change these numbers at the end to just say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next, we have a couple of fields down here. We want to show you what it looks like when you're creating a brand new merge field. So we've got 3 fields: preferred project start date, preferred days of the week for weekly meetings, and project priority. So this is data that we want to collect from the prospect when they're filling out this proposal. And then we want this data to write back into Salesforce. We ran into a nuance with the date field that we want to make sure that you're prepared for. So we're going to add a new field. Our source object is going to be the opportunity. And then our field is the preferred project start date. We're going to allow write back to Salesforce. This is important, or else the data will not write back. You can choose whether or not you want it to be required. In this case, we do want it to be required. And then this is going to be the anchor text that we're going to set up. Project date _braces_r_text. We will create the second one. This will be our preferred days of the week. We want this to be required, and we want it to write back to Salesforce as well. And we will add our third one. This is going to write back. This one is not going to be required. And this will be our anchor text that we use. And we will click save. Okay, now I need to add these autoplace fields to our document. So this will look like this. We'll replace the R with a 1. Then we have op days of the week. And then our project priority. Now, the next thing we want to show you here is that DocuSign has these fields called anchor text fields. You can see N1, S1, T1, D1. These are standard, which will pull the name, signer, title, and date signed for the signer 1 or signer 2. So we wanted to show you how these will work as well. Our next step is to change all of these autoplace fields to be in a white font. This will make sure that the text doesn't show up on our documents and you'll just see the field merge with the data. Okay, so we've got this document all set up. Let's save this. All right, let's go back to our DocuSign envelope template. Let's click next. And you can configure auto reminders, the number of days before the envelope expires. We can configure if we want it to write back. And then you can do your field updates if you wanted to. We really go into this extensively in your different options in our initial setup video for DocuSign. So you'll want to check out the chapters there for additional insights. And then here's where you can create the button. I never have good luck and this button never gets created. We'll see if it works today. I'll click save and finish. And it says your template was saved. And we'll go back to templates. And then here is my DocuSign envelope record with my signers. So now let's go to an opportunity and let's see if this button was added. And I do not see it. So let's go ahead and see if the button was created. We'll go to buttons, links, and actions, and we can see that the button was not created. That's okay. I'll give you the button information. So we're gonna create a new button or link, and I will give you this URL in the description in case this happens to you too. We're gonna call this DocuSign Upload Document. And then here is the URL that we're going to use. And this ID right here, we're going to put in the ID of the DocuSign envelope record. So you just click on that record and you grab the ID from the URL and you paste it in there. And then you just update the title of your button there. And then you'll click save. Oh, you need to make it a detail page button. So we'll edit this. We'll make it a detail page button and we'll make it open in the existing window without sidebar or header. Now we need to add it to our page layout. Now let's go to our opportunity and just refresh. And we can see our button is now on our page. All right, we will click DocuSign Upload Document. We will upload our proposal. And then you can rename it here. And then we need to select our recipients, which should automatically come in from our opportunity contact roles. You can click next. Now we should see that these fields are automatically coming in. So we did program our account name in our phone. We can see that our three products came in with their correct pricing. And then on our second page, we have field merges. You can just check those to make sure that they are connected to Salesforce, and they are. They will all come in. Now, one thing I want to point out to you is that whenever you're creating the custom field from inside of Salesforce like this, there's a couple of things that you can't program. So let's pull up our three new fields. So here's the three new fields that we just created. So if we go to our preferred project start date and we click the settings, we can see that we have more options down here to configure these. Now, the most important part for this particular field is it has to be a date. If you have a custom field in Salesforce that's a date field and then it's not a date field on the DocuSign side, it's not going to populate back into Salesforce. So you want to make sure that you make the validation type a date, and then you can always change the font of these fields and the color from here as well. So let me do the account name and phone. It's actually this one down here, op account name. So I'm just going to change the font. And then I'll change it here as well. Okay, and then we're going, since we made changes to all those field merges, we're going to discard this. And then we're going to regenerate the document. So we'll click DocuSign Upload Document. Because whenever you make changes to your custom fields like that, it doesn't apply to the fields in the template. We'll upload our document here. We'll rename it. We'll skip to our prepare and send step. And we should see that our fonts are different. And then when we fill out the proposal, that project start date should be a date field. So we can see that this is now in Calibri. And then let's just make sure our signature tags are all there, title, date. So all those populated nicely. So we can see the yellow ones are assigned to Uncle Fester, which is correct. The blue ones are assigned to me, which is correct. So then we will send this out for signature. Okay, and we'll just show you what this is looking like for signer one. So we can see that signer one is able to update the phone number if needed, but can't update the product information. And then we can see here that the project start date is required. It is a date field. We can see that we can put in our preferred days for weekly meetings. And then here would be the project priority. And then we'd sign here. This needs to say Uncle Fester. You can see I was testing with Mickey Mouse earlier. All right, finish. Okay, so Uncle Fester / Mickey Mouse is done signing. So now it should route to me. I'm going to sign off camera here. Okay, we're all done signing. And so we should see these three fields here get updated whenever the DocuSign envelope comes back into Salesforce. So we have the DocuSign status record here. You can see it doesn't say completed just yet. And now it shows completed, and we should see our three fields are updated on our opportunity. And that's it. That's how you use those auto place fields to make you more efficient with your documents. That's it. That's a wrap. We hope you gained some valuable insights on how to use auto place fields with your documents. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss the upcoming videos on how to further work with DocuSign and Salesforce. In the next video, we will show you how to write a flow that will create Salesforce contract records when the completed DocuSign envelope comes back into Salesforce. If you have any questions about this video, or if you would like to see a tutorial on a different Salesforce topic, let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.